Has the pandemic finally exposed Reaganism for what it is? Check this out. Leave your comments, ding the bell, share it with your friends, and subscribe to our channel. You know, this is Professor Richard Wolff, the economist, co-founder of democracyatwork.info, author of numerous books, his most recent, Understanding Socialism. Democracyatwork.info is the website, as well as rdwolff with two Fs, .com. You can tweet him at Prof. Wolff. And Professor Wolff, I'm curious, I want to get into a conversation with you about kind of post-capitalism or, you know, the new normal. But before we do that, real quickly, I'm curious your take on what the Fed, you know, what Jerome Powell announced yesterday at the Jackson Hole virtual event, where he basically said, we're going to try and keep inflation above 2%. What is this? Why? Can they pull it off? Does it matter? What's going on?
Yeah, well, this needs to be unpacked because the language Mr. Powell uses is really much more about mystifying than clarifying. Here's what it means. We are in the depths of a serious depression in which tens of millions of people have lost their job and a good number of them have no prospect of getting it back. Serious, severe unemployment on a scale we have not seen since the Great Depression of the 1930s, number one. Number two, the government of the United States is not doing anything about it. That is, we are not doing what we did in the 1930s, which is to create government jobs, to say to the people, if you can't get a job in the private sector, if the capitalist employers either don't want or don't care about what happens to you or want to hire you, the government will. That would be the solution we could and should use right now. But if Mr. Powell knows that the government of the United States, surely under the Republicans and Trump, have no intention of doing it. Obviously, they haven't. But if you listen to the Biden Democrats, you don't see much more. $300 billion, which is the number he's thrown around, would not begin to create a public employment program of the sort we need. So what needs to be done isn't being done, isn't even being contemplated. So what's left? Long-term unemployment in the tens of millions, that's going to shake this society to its foundations. So they're desperate, and that's really the important thing here. What are we going to do? And what he said yesterday is the following. We're going to keep interest rates virtually zero. We're going to pump more money, I'm talking trillions of dollars, into the economy, and if that creates an inflation, a rising prices beyond our previous limit of so-called 2%, well, so be it. Things are so desperate, we're going to have to risk an inflation because the alternative is even worse for us. Another sign of devastation. And let me finish by saying this is unbelievably bad news for the American economy that they're this desperate. But also, if they let an inflation go, and by proclaiming the 2%, he's averaging what will come in the years ahead, which is much more than 2%, because it will be averaged with recent years, which have come in at much below 2%. So what we're seeing is a prognosis from the man in charge that we're going to see prices rising 3, 4, 5, 6, who knows what percentage. And given a country in which most people are having a hard time making ends meet as it is, try to factor in rising prices, and you are proposing something that risks savaging the working class of this country.
And that President Biden would inherit an economy sort of like the one Jimmy Carter inherited from Nixon and Ford, you know, with all this inflation baked into it. I'm curious if it seems like what you're saying basically is there's two ways to reinflate an economy that has crashed. One would be to inject money at the bottom, at the level of the worker, through a massive government jobs program like FDR did. That worked. That got us out of the Great Depression. The other way to do it is to try to stimulate the economy the way that Reagan tried to do when there was a slight recession when he came into office, which is pour money into the banks and into the billionaires and hope that some fraction of it trickles down to the bottom. And that Powell is basically saying, we're going to double double down on the trickle-down strategy. We're not going to feed the bottom up. We're going to feed the top down. And it's so ineffective that the side effect of this is going to be massive inflation, which is just going to devastate people on fixed incomes. But that's mostly old people and people on welfare, so who cares about that? Is that a good summary?
Absolutely. Yes, and I would only add the part you left out. They've been doing that already. We know what is going on. The money is not going into creating jobs, nor will it. It's going into the stock market where there has been a massive inflation. It's just wonderful good news for the few who own significant amounts of shares. It leaves the rest of the economy in a shambles. But that failure is being rationalized by the Fed in order to continue the very policies that produced that failure. Historians will look back on this moment and shake their heads at so much going on in this country, but this action by the Fed, the refusal to face up to the failure of what they've done and the need to intervene directly to give people jobs and incomes, stupefying, really genuinely stupefying.
Well, and I think it's a great segue, we have 3 minutes left, into my question, is this the new normal? It seems to me that the trend that Reaganism put us on of wiping out small and medium-sized businesses by not enforcing the anti-monopoly laws and other policies, wiping out the middle class by lowering taxes on the very, very wealthy, things like that, that what the coronavirus has done is simply accelerate. It's not like there's something new going on here. It has simply accelerated a trend that has been going on for 40 years, and that a lot of these low-income jobs and a lot of these small employers, these small companies, small and medium-sized companies that are going out of business and that are losing their, and the people who are losing their jobs are literally never going to get them back. That this is like the end point of Reaganism happening in 1 year when it would have been maybe another 10 or 20 years. What do you think of that analysis?
You know, I like it. I think that it's correct. I think you already saw it, that you didn't react to the dot-com crisis in 2000 in a way that you could have. You didn't learn anything. You did the same thing on a larger scale against the subprime mortgage crisis in 2008. That didn't work either. So now you're tripling down, if you like, by doing the same thing again. I fear that what you have going on here is a willingness of those at the top in the pursuit of ever more wealth on the fantastic scales of Jeffrey Bezos and all the rest, that the mass of the American people can be reduced to what we used to watch on television in National Geographic programs about poor countries far away. We're going to have enclaves of the rich surrounded by masses of people barely getting by. It's an amazing thing to try to do in any country, but in one that used to celebrate the big middle class and the American dream, I don't think it's politically doable.
Yeah, I worked in Bogota, Colombia, in Lima, Peru, in Mexico City, in numerous cities around Eastern Africa and Southeast Asia. And one of the things that I saw over and over and over again were slums, basically. They had different names for them, that were fenced in. They put these giant concrete fences around them with razor wire on top of them and basically keep the slum dwellers in. You know, they could go in and out on the buses to go to work, you know, to serve the wealthy people or even the middle class, but that was it. Do you see that coming to America?
Yes. The only question is whether the mass of people who for a while in the 20th century were strong enough to rise up during the Great Depression and to demand to be treated differently and to succeed in that demand. It's unclear to me that that generation or even its children and grandchildren will accept being pushed back. You know, that genie once out of the bottle, it's not so easy to put it back. And I think there are the political struggles that are coming.